selling for my father and for me and for my brother, for my family, to keep this tradition alive. And it's, that's why I always say it's not only a work for us, it's something more, you know, it's a passion, and it's Italian know-how to be shared with worldwide, in fact.
L'importante è sapere insegnare bene, insegnare questo lavoro ai dipendenti. È importante che i dipendenti riescano a farlo con passione, con un certo amore. E anche se è molto difficile e qualche volta diventa un rapporto di amore e odio, quasi come avere una bella amante, però certe volte ci vuole di ammazzarla.
La storia del sassofono, начавшаяся около 170 лет назад, полна легендарных имен. И это не только имена великих музыкантов, сделавших саксофон поистине одним из самых популярных инструментов современности, но и марки самих саксофонов. Кон, Кинг, Элхарт, Юлиус Келверт, Анри Сельман. Эти имена известны любому саксофонисту. Можно спорить, какие инструменты объективно лучше. Старинные, изготовленные вручную, как, например, этот кон 1922 года выпуска. Или же новые, изготовленные на современном оборудовании. Как, например, популярнейшая Yamaha. Ведь технически современные инструменты ничем не уступают старинным образцам и по многим характеристикам даже превосходят их. Но все же многие музыканты считают, что индустриализация лишает инструменты индивидуальности, эксклюзивности и шарма мастеровых инструментов. Поэтому роль ручного труда в производстве инструментов кастом-класса всегда выше, чем в саксофонах массового производства.
Noi siamo pochi, siamo una decina di dipendenti che lavorano in ditta e una decina di artigiani che collaborano esternamente. E pensiamo che sia il numero ideale per mantenere questa caratteristica di produzione. Diventando più grandi perderemo questa nostra caratteristica di strumenti eccezionali. Ed è molto importante la scelta, la crescita dei dipendenti. Noi la nostra forza è quella di lavorare, di seguire direttamente noi il lavoro in famiglia, di avere anche qualche dipendente, nostri parenti. Nella nostra azienda lavora anche mio cognato, due miei cugini. E è appunto è essenziale controllare e far crescere la manodopera. È importante che gli operai, se possibile, imparino questo mestiere e lo facciano fino a quando vanno all'età della pensione, altrimenti è difficile raggiungere dei risultati ottimali.
First of all, we are manufacturers, technicians. We didn't think on how to promote the saxophones. So we were trying to figure out who we are, where we are, what do we want to do, you know. And we pretty early realized that because of the importance of what our ancestors did, it was very respectful to maintain most of their ideas, try to improve, upgrade their ideas, but not change the path. Because if we started making a saxophone 1875, that's why I pointed out this date, that means we had a great ideas already, because 1875 is very close to the invention of the saxophone. It's something about 25, 30 years after the invention, which was in Belgium, here in Europe. Our company company was founded many, many years ago. Most important date is 1818. Two of my ancestors went to Milan and they met a guy making little flutes, recorders, flutes with no keys. And he was a very nice craftsman for working the wood. Mr. Luvoni sold his know-how and a little machineries to these two guys coming from Quarna. Forni and Rampone. In those years electricity was not available, so the very first atelier here in Quarna, in this town, was based next to a stream for using the power coming from the water, using the water mill. The next very important date I will underline is 1875, when we concentrated on a saxophone. Still keeping alive the production of all the other horns like flugelhorns, trumpets, clarinets, etc., etc. You know, flute was a very important part of our history because both Agostino and the son Teodoro were flute players, and particularly Teodoro was a flute player at La Scala Theater in Milan. Mr. Cazzani was a watchmaker and a musical instruments repairer based in Milan, and they made the two companies together, Rampone and Cazzani. Our slogan, the vintage warmest sound in a modern saxophone, it's more related to the way we produce and we make our body and the geometry of our body. But then for sure, a great saxophone made in 2011 must have a very comfortable keyworks. And we believe that the full line of our Rampones has a really very comfortable mechanic. We want the players to be comfortable while playing, and the final result of our keyworks is compromising between many different ends and many different needs coming from the players. Players here. They came in and I was not so aware of the situation, so I was listening to them playing. And they were reporting, okay, you listen my Selmer, because most of the times they had a Selmer. They were playing the Selmer and then they played the Rampone. Oh, great sound, very different. But listen, when I do this note, it's different from the Selmer. And at the very beginning we thought, okay, we must make our saxophone sound more like the Selmer. But after a while we realized, no. We don't want that, because we are changing the character of our saxophone if we move too much to the Selmer. We want our saxophone to be easy to drive, but maintaining the same the Rampone original former features, you know. And we believe after 20 years we reached a very nice result. See the reason to make something which is a copy of Selmer, like many others did, because there is the Selmer. If I want to play the Selmer, I know that's the best option. I don't want to buy a copy of that, in my personal opinion. I want to buy a Rampone saxophone, and I want to hear a different sound coming out from my horns when the players play them. It's like to say, oh, Ferrari is a great car, okay, but maybe even Porsche is a great car. So it's a question of taste. If you want to go for the Italian choice, you go for Ferrari.
We'll be right back. Buongiorno, signor. Rampone Cazzani.
Come?
Rampone Cazzani.
Rampone Cazzani degli strumenti.
Degli strumenti.
Non siamo di qua.
Devi chiedere qua.
Da qua, però.
Manconiere.
Davide, vieni un secondo.
David.
Dimitri.
Svidania.
Rampone Cazzani.
Rampone Cazzani.
Sì.
Ok.
Mettile. We are based in a very particular area of Italy, above the lakes. In fact, we are in the Alps. Pretty unusual for our customers, for people to see a saxophone company on top of the Alps, in fact.
Alle mie spalle ci sono i due campanili di Quarna, con le loro campane, le due voci che richiamavano non solo alle funzioni religiose, ma anche alle occasioni importanti del paese. Da qui arriviamo al pittore Carlo Casanova, uno dei più grandi acquafortisti del Novecento italiano, che era originario di Cremona ma ha vissuto gli ultimi anni della sua vita a Quarna ed ha, tra le tante sue opere, realizzato questa acqueforte che ha appunto chiamato Le Due Voci, dove si vedono i due campanili e due chiese di Quarna.
Trying to be very close to the old tradition and to show that we are really proud to make saxophones up here in the Alps, in this little village. So we decided to dedicate this two voices model to Carlo Casanova and reproduce on each of the two voices saxophones this painting. This is the two church towers from the village. Le due voci, that means two voices in English. And I thought this was perfect. Something that it didn't happen by chance. I really decided to pick that name and to use it for our new line, which is the two voices coming from the two different metals and the two voices, the due voci, coming from the title of this great work from the painter. This is a very special engraving, all straight line, reproducing exactly that one. And for sure, this is a limited edition together with the solid silver saxophones we offer. While you are hitting the bell with a wooden hammer, you will create some creases, pretty bad creases also. And then you need, as we showed, the fire to make again the metal smoother. Otherwise, you risk the piece to break, you know. And like that, with the fire, you are making the metal again smooth, and then you can go on again massaging with this hammer, which looks like for bad customers, but it's for making great bells. I like to show you an idea of how we experiment sometimes in a very simple way when we decide to go for new metals. I can show you three different examples and three different sounds even before blowing inside the tube. If you take this arm, is an alto body, and if I take it like that, you see most of the body free for vibrating, and I hit it, it sounds pretty much like a bell from a church, you know. So I can feel there is pretty much high harmonics in the sound, you know, but it's pretty well balanced. Also, brilliant, but not so brilliant, and this is brass. If I take the bronze, which is a harder metal, then I get this, which is not so far, but... And like that we start to figure out, oh, maybe this metal, we can use it to go that direction and to achieve this kind of sound. And then if we take the copper, which is very soft, you'll be pretty amazed. I like the copper saxophones, but the first time I hit it one, I was not very happy about the result. Listen. Not very, you know, you don't go crazy for this sound. But then if you make it, shape it like a saxophone and you blow into the tube, the result is very interesting either. So again, copper. Brass. And moving to the very present sound. Brilliant sound, bronze. Also, you can still hear the sound. It stays for longer. I don't believe when I hear other people maybe speaking about special alloys made intentionally for make the saxophone. This is not possible, because if you go to a big supplier and you ask for something special, they want to sell you tons of this metal. You have to be careful yourself and select in between their offer and choose the metal which is a better match for your bore, for your philosophy, you know. We have our special recipe, so we like to buy only this kind of brass, this kind of bronze. Most of them are from Switzerland and Germany.
La maggior parte degli attrezzi e delle attrezzature che vedete qui nell'officina meccanica sono oggetti parecchio vecchi, oggetti di misurazione, torni, prese, mole, tutte attrezzature che sono state acquistate in tempi anche abbastanza remoti e poi adattate da noi per costruire il saxofono.
Even these tools are handmade by me. My master engraver used to tell me, you'll be a nice engraver when you are able to make your tools by yourself. And then my master engraver teach me to check the sharpness of the tool on my nails. If it's making this effect, then it's fine. It's fine, it's sharp enough, you know.
We believe it's very important to be so attached to the product, because we also can pass this to our workers to show if there is something wrong in production. Sometimes they complain because they tell, oh, you know, for making this by hand it's really hard and it's not easy, maybe we should buy some machines for making this. And we say, no, for making something unique we need to make it by hand, because it has to be unique.
Puoi mandare giù.